Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear viewers, inshallah, in this short video, I'm going to share our weekly gift. As we all know that in a few days, we will be entering the month of Ramadan. And we can use the month of Ramadan as a platform where we are going to inculcate a few new things with the intention that we're going to maintain them throughout our entire life. So without taking much more time, I would like to get into the gift straight away. After Maghrib, may it be the month of Ramadan, may it be outside the month of Ramadan, we should understand that that time is very, very precious. The time after Maghrib is very, very precious, as is the time after Fajr. It is very, very special. Now, Nabi Akrim Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has made mention of many things that we should be doing after Salatul Maghrib. And if we do them, indeed we will reap great, great benefit. So I would like you to remember as a reference, there are two surahs that I would like my noble viewers to read after Salatul Maghrib. One is surah number 32, known as Surah Alif Lam Mim Sajda. And the second surah is surah number 67, Surah Mulk. It seems like that these two surahs are partners. It is amazing that Surah Alif Lam Mim Sajda consists of 30 verses and Surah Mulk consists of 30 verses as well. Now the scholars of Hadith have collected the fada'il of Surah Alif Lam Mim Sajda and Surah Mulk. And when we study the collective fada'il, the attributes pertaining to these two surahs, we will be amazed. I'm going to share those fada'il with you today, and this will encourage my noble viewers, brothers and sisters and their children to read these two surahs after Salatul Maghrib. May it be the month of Ramadan, may it be outside the month of Ramadan, but we can use the month of Ramadan as a platform. Now, the first fadilat pertaining to Surah Mulk and Surah Alif Lam Mim Sajda is that Nabi Kareem Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never used to sleep without the recital of these two surahs. This practice in itself is sufficient for us. That it was so dear to the Nabi of Allah to recite these two surahs that he did not sleep until he recited these two surahs. So take that as a platform from which we are going to inculcate these two surahs. The individual fadilat of Surah Mulk is well known to the Muslim Ummah, as made mention by Nabi Akrim Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the person that used to recite this surah that consists of 30 verses, surah number 67, indeed this surah on the day of judgment will intercede for him. It will intercede for him. Yani it will make shafa'at for this person. And indeed, when the Quran, the kalam of Allah Almighty intercedes for a person, there is no reason for the intercession to be rejected. And that's why Nabi Akareem Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that I desire that each believer learn this surah off by heart and place it in the heart. So it is important that we try to learn this surah off by heart as well, Surah Mulk. We've got 30 days in the month of Ramadan. Even if we take one verse per day, inshallah, by the end, we can learn the entire surah off by heart. Furthermore, if we learn two ayat per day, inshallah, we can cover both surahs, Surah Mulk and Surah Alif Lam Mim Sajda. In one hadith, it has been made mention that a person who recites the two surahs after Maghrib, before Isha, it is like he has stood in Laylatul Qadr. And we have studied Laylatul Qadr extensively, in which Nabi Kareem Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Man qama Laylatul Qadr imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." A person who stands in Laylatul Qadr with yaqeen, with faith, with belief that he will be rewarded, Allah forgives all his sins. If a person recites these two surahs after Maghrib, before Isha, it is like he has stood in Laylatul Qadr. So my dear viewers, brothers and sisters, take the month of Ramadan as the platform from which you are going to fly high with these two surahs. Learn these two surahs off by heart. If you can't, at least open the Quran after Maghrib, before Isha, and recite these two surahs, and make the month of Ramadan the practicing month, and then basically sustain this practice for the rest of your life. Allah Rabbul Izzat grant each one of us the ability to practice. Pray for your brother. I pray for you. And both of us, inshallah, will make it across into the gardens of Jannah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.